friends, this is Dr. Nikisha Jariwala. Once again, welcome to the tutorial of ASP.NET. Today we will see how we can access controls of master page from the content page. First of all, what is master page? Master page is a page within ASP.NET through we can give uniform and consistent layout to our web pages. And the content page is a child page which is created from the master page. So let's see an example.
As we want to access the controls of master page from the child page, first of all we need to create the master page. As we have seen in the previous example, I have already created the website with the name ASP.NET tutorials. Within that I have created one folder, and within that folder I will add one master page. So right click, add new item. From that we will select master page. By default the name of the master page is masterpage.master, and we will click on add button. Here, as we can see, there is one control, that is content placeholder control. This control will contain the dynamic content of the content page. But first of all, as we want to design the master page, we will remove this control from here. So we have deleted the control. Now let's design the master page. We will add the table of 3 rows, 1 column. So first row will be used as a header, last row will be used as a footer, and the second row will be used to put menu and the content placeholder control. So within this row we will place another table of 1 row, 2 columns. So in this column we will place the menu, and within this column we will able to place our content placeholder control, which will be used on the content page. So within the header, first of all I will write welcome, and then I will place one text box control. Let's change the ID property of the text box control. I will write it as a txt name. Now within the second column we can place the menu control, as it is a navigation control, so it is available in the navigation tab. So this is a menu control. Within this column we need to place content placeholder control. It is available over here. So this is our content placeholder control, and the last column will be used as a footer. Let's write some copyright information. For example, ampersand copy semicolon, copyrights reserved. Let's align it to the center. So align property, we will set it to center, so it will appear like this. This is a copyright symbol. It is possible with the help of this ampersand copy semicolon, and then it is written copyright reserved. So this is our simple master page. Let's save the master page. Now from this master page we will create a content page. So again right click on the folder, add new item, web form. Now as we want to create a content page from the master page, we need to select this checkbox, that is select master page. We will give the name it as a child page .aspx. So as we have selected, we need to create content page from the master page, so it is asking for the master page, so it's over here, and click on OK. So we will get the layout of the master page on the content page. Now as I want to access the controls of the master page from the content page, I need to design the content page within the content placeholder control. So let's write over here, enter your name, and beside that we will place one text box control, Let's change the ID property of the text box control to txt value. Beside that, let's place one button control. We will give the ID it is btn change, and text property we will set as a change. Now on this button control, we need to write the code which will assign the value to the text box control of the master page from the text box which we have placed within the content placeholder on the child page. So let's open its event, that is the click event. Within that click event, let's write the code. Deem txt as text box. So over here, txt is the reference which we have created of the text box control. After that, txt is equal to me dot master dot find control, and we need to find the control, that is txt name. So let's understand this statement. Me, that is the current page, instance of the current page. Master, that is the master page of the current page. Over here, current page is our child page, and the master page of this child page is the master page dot master. So it will reference to that master page. From that master page, we need to find the control. So with the help of find control method, we will able to find this txt name text box which is present on our master page. And after that, we need to write txt dot text is equal to txt value dot text. Let's save all the pages. We will set child page as a start page, and let's execute the page. So this is the thing, that is enter your name, text box, and the change button which we have kept on the child page, and this message, that is welcome, and this text box we have kept on the master page. So let's add over here, I'm writing my name and then I'm clicking on the change button. So by clicking on the change button, the value which I have entered within the text box on the content page, that is our child page, appears within the text box which is present on the master page. So this is all about the example. Please comment your suggestions in the comment section.
If the tutorial is helpful to you, please like the video and also subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss the update. Thank you.